Hi everyone, this is Leo and welcome back to our App Inventor 2 tutorials. So today is lesson 4. Before our lessons begins, let's open our lesson 3 project and load the emulator because we will be doing some kind of layouts and arrangement stuffs in this lesson. So let's start. Okay, so in App Inventor, when we want to align our components, it's not that easy because as you can see, we cannot achieve what we want in just a viewer. So that's what layout's gonna help us. So I want you guys to drag a horizontal arrangement component in our viewer. So the layout things basically helps us to arrange different components, and we can set the position we want them to be. So horizontally, I want my two buttons to align horizontally, which each of them occupy 50%, that's half of our screen. So we have our horizontal arrangement component and we just put our buttons inside here, so you can see. Well, the first thing we have to do is to change some kind of properties here under the properties tab. I want it to be center and top of our screen. So it seems nothing's happened. Okay, you can see here is just aligned on the top left corner, right? So we have to set our buttons here, find the width and change it to 50%. We have to do this to both of our buttons. Oops. Remember, press OK. Now you can see our two buttons, which each of them just occupied 50% of our screen. So you can try the buttons, and also you may want to try to set the percentage if you are not happy with what you see here. You know, just try things out. And here, view parent. And it just aligned to the center. Okay, so this is the horizontal arrangement. So now we want to try the vertical arrangement. So App Inventor is kind of special. You can see under the components is like the Windows files management system is have a hierarchy, and you can put layout components under a layout components. So I want to put our image here and put our buttons here. Okay, so just like this. Okay. Well, here, because if we hit the high button, the button become the image become invisible, so it has nothing. So it is going to align according to the button's width. So you can just try different width and height setting and happy to play with the laid out arrangements. Well, one thing to remind you guys is if you want to delete layout components, remember to drag your buttons or image or every components out before deleting it, because if you delete it, delete the layout arrangement, all of your other components inside that arrangement component will be also deleted. So just remember this. Okay, so this is pretty much about the layout things. You can try different settings. In this lesson, I'm not going to talk about scroll arrangement because you can see we have limited number of components, so using a scroll is not that effective, right? So yeah, the last thing I want to talk about in this lesson is about our last week leader challenge. If you can see it, I just post a comment in YouTube where I challenge you guys to use only a single button to control the visibility of the image. So here's the answer. I have it here in my Lesson3 extra. So it is very simple, just an image, just a button. You click it, disappear, click it once again, it shows up. So how do I do this? Here is very simple and I will explain it step by step. So remember, when we click a button, we do something and we want to set our image visibility to something. And here what these two little blocks represent is kind of tricky, and you have to like think it, use your imagination, right? So image1.visible, this is a variable. It is talking about whether or not the image is visible at the point of time. So when it is visible, this means it's true, and if it's not invisible, it is not visible, you cannot see it, it's false. So what I want to do is when my button is visible, I want to set it to invisible. So this little not gonna help me to invert the state of the image visibility. So here I'll just put it back. So when I click the button, if my image is visible, I set it to not visible. If my image is not visible, I set it to not invisible, which means visible. So it is a little trickier, it's not magic, but it just works in the way that I just use a simple not blocks. So I think our Lesson 4 just ends here. And before our lessons ends, let's talk about what we are going to do next in next lesson, next week. So we just go through some simple functions, and it's a good start to start talking about variables. So you can see here, this is a variable, and maybe we can try numbers and calculations next week, maybe. Yeah, just remember to save your project, and I will put this project and upload it so you can download this little program in the link in the description. So see you guys next week.